In a $300 million pitch to parents, the opposition is promising school students a free lunch. Matthew Guy says he'll save an average family $5,000 a year in the race to Victoria's election. State political reporter Mark Santomartino.
Eating lunch every day for three boys takes time.
This is Sam's because it's wholemeal.
Time before school many parents simply don't have.
Thanks.
I don't want kids going to school and having fatty cheese pasta. I want them to have a proper healthy lunch to keep them focused.
Today, in his own kitchen, Matthew Guy pledged $300 million to a pilot program. If elected, it would start at select public schools in the second half of next year, providing free lunches designed by nutritionists.
It'll be for government schools, prep to year 12. Non-government schools can opt in. They can buy their way in.
We know the problem. Estimates of between 13 and 33% of students experience food insecurity. So if the best in the world's doing this, why wouldn't we copy it?
The idea is modelled on similar programs that run in the UK and New Zealand and has won the approval of Victoria's Council of Social Service.
I think that when it comes to making sure that kids are fed, they're ready to learn, that's a policy that everyone can get behind.
Daniel Andrews, who announced a master plan for Sunshine Station today, started the School Breakfast Club program in 2016. So far, it's served 25 million free meals.
Different sides will make different announcements. I would just make the point that these are the very same people who cancelled a program called Free Fruit Friday.
Matthew Guy says his free lunches would cost the state $200 million a year once it's available at every government school.
This is just a simple way that the government can help with cost of living. Up to $5,000 a year the average family can save by adopting this program.
And Mark joins me live now. Mark, the Premier has a new name for Airport Rail.
Alicia, in some ways it was the most curious part in the middle of Daniel Andrews' plan to redevelop Sunshine Station and have it rival something like Southern Cross. The Premier made a point of calling it the SRL Airport line. Of course, when complete, it will make up part of the suburban rail loop, but in reality it's a completely separate project with separate funding and a separate business case. So why the change? Well, for months we've heard the opposition say it would shelve the suburban rail loop. Matthew Guy does want to audit but ultimately build a train line to the airport. But today's change does muddy that water for voters, and Daniel Andrews was explicit about what he wants Victorians to believe, saying audit is just a fancy word for cuts. If there's a change of government, the big build will be no more, and too many jobs depend on this. In some ways, every job depends on this. Fighting words with just 27 days to go, Alicia.
Yes, the clock is ticking. OK, Mark, thank you.